Yo!
Yo! I've been standing in this cold for 5 fucking hours! So I was going to battle, but I think it'd be more productive to hit him with a judo flip. Mate, you look as out of place in a battle as fucking Lumos Quiff. I should get somebody to beatbox while I knock your head about and just call it a musical. The outcome of this battle is so fucking predictable. I actually got Jamie Woods to come dressed for a fucking funeral. Barry Dyer, you've changed. See, I'm coming with that great pal. You're not a great rapper. You look like James Arthur's gay father. Your eyebrows have no standard. Check them out. They're a mess, man. There's no dispute. You look like a bent banging major poof with a sweatband that's made of pubes. Your fake is crew. A breaking two. Display I'm ruthless, true enough. Your crew is called the Dungeon Dwellers. After the modern adaption of the board game Dungeons and Dragons, well, you are clearly cool as fuck. You're nothing but a useless cunt. You will never be in Danny's zone. You spend Friday nights at your ma's alone with a bag of blowing, a camera rolling, patios and a pack of smoke. Tick inside your dad, of course, and basket glowing. The fact you know you won't need to pay his ass a taxi home.
Oh, yes.
I'm coming with that Gallus flow. He's anti-bagging mental woman. Your bud's so fat she gets her fucking spray tanned on at West Coast Customs. She's an ecto-buzzing, 30-something, geezer in its tail eye, with a 12-inch overhang from eating the steak pies. That bitch could jump in a shower and her feet would remain dry. But I'd still fuck that bitch. I'd tell her of the lovers we could be. I would walk her in the summer breeze and feed her chunky cheese. I'm a romantic, so that means I would never bust a nut up on a crusty muff, up out it and leave. I'd tell her if I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together and do the fuck away with Z's.
Check it.
A wild ratata has appeared.
You look like a midget Mexican bandit spastic going through one hell of a crack withdrawal. You make the borrowers look tall enough to play professional basketball. But that ain't all. This twat so small battle rap should have a height restriction. Your shite was spitting and the only time you're winning against me is if this shit was a motherfucking limbo competition. See, everything you talking is crap. He came and slipped some bodies and bags. Danny, you look like Dynamo the Magician and spit an image if the magician's assistant accidentally saw him in half. Small little rat, you are not in my class, you fucking vertically challenged bastard. You are hopeless and that is blatant. First guy in the place to smell a fart, last one to notice that it's raining. And I know there must be painting, being a mad creature with rat features, looking like one of Santa's little elves. I will damage this midget's health, and why the fuck do you always stand about swaying side to side like you're about to actually piss yourself? Him and his missus go shopping, and she drops him in the children's play area. He's left by his gimpy self, and it's always a Tesco because every little helps.
Nice, man.
Thinks he can win battles because after he's done putting pitiful minimal effort into crafting a sentence, he jumps about and spits his punches loudly. We guy, you need to realise there's a thin line between having a presence and standing on stage and shouting, sounding like a fucking downy. Don't doubt me, because Z's a beast for his speech. Defeating weak MCs like Weedy Weekly. Ain't no way in fucking hell I'ma let this teensy weensy Ouija beat me. Time.
Yeah. Oh.
I don't know whether to punch him or throttle him instead. He said I look like Dynamo. Mate, I won't put a phone inside your bottle. I'll put that bottle in your head. Yes. Oh. Because you know that I spit it, mate, and I'm sick with spitting. And stop asking me to sell your CD on to people. I am not that good a magician. see my bars, mate? They're really awesome. I'm about to leave them deep in coffins. You're called Z because your teeth are rotten and so spaced out that they actually look like a zebra crossing. Yeah. People say that Z is awesome. Ain't no fucking chance this cunt is better. Your crew is called the Dungeon Dwellers because your butt's got a fanny like a fucking cellar. And Grant's your mucker.
Hold it down, man. Hold it down.
Listen, this part's good. Grant's your mucker, your first contender. But it's not a gimmick that this love is proven. He can open up his mouth and blow a Grant like an alcoholic college student. You're a faggot, mate. There's no confusion. I'll fuck your bud till she's shivering pale. She's got a fanny like the Tottenham Hotspurs at similar tails, because anytime you want out, it's 80 million for bail. She goes around Glasgow trying to dig in her nails, flying fanny to anyone that's battling. Me, your bud's probably had more in the West on her arse than fucking Kim Kardashian. I'm kidding. He's not got a bud to embarrass him. He would never fuck a bitch or try to get head or try his neck at pulling bobs at clubs. It's not a prize he's kept. No cyber sex and higher death. No bud could get this guy erect. Cause this kiddie bashing dick captain's got more minors in his observation than Stevie Wonder on a driving test. My throat is going. Freestyle.
Hold it down, man.
I'm losing my voice. Freestyle, let the skills prevail. You make horrorcore tracks about killing males. I mean, come on, and fuck Z, you're built like jails.
Yeah!
Stick in sex,
so never fucking talk to me again or uppercut you, make you backflip. You ever, I mean ever, call me out to a battle again, I will kick your ass for here to fucking Perth. Whatever the fuck that is.
Yeah! Make some noise for me! Of course I'm coming with small jokes. You're a small bloke. What the fuck were you expecting, twat? Kinda hard not to when I see you pull up to Livingston in a car this size. Attached to a fucking Scare Electrics track. Listen, you fucking Neddy Rat. You're no gangland authentic. You're a transgender ferret. Shadow people's Dan DeVito, tiny body but a massive ego. Battle me, don't catch a crack cerebral. I'm a fucking raging bull like De Niro. This challenge is a lower caliber. Me and this fucking twat ain't equal. You fit the description of a Robin Pikey that shoplifts children's underpants from Matalan. I see you in every other battle, you wee Pikey. Stop being disrespectful, asking every cunt else if they would like to buy a fucking caravan. Right. Fuck your battle plan. At a glance, you don't have a chance. This spineless rat is see-through. If you're a freak show fanatic or a circus promoter, this might be the man to speak to. Keep in mind, I produced the instrumental for your biggest hit, you midget prick. Quit biting the hand that feeds you.
Ooh.
Without my beats, you can bet he sucks. This insignificant midget's heavy fucked. You only rap so you get the chance to stand on a stage and feel the same height as the rest of us. Fuck this pretentious cunt. I come spitting magnificent, ripping and mangling mics. I mutilate this microscopic shadow munchkin like he's nothing fucking half in his life. Motherfucker, you can't get hyped. Danny's getting dismantled tonight. Fuck battling me, you look like you're already losing that lifelong lasting battle with hype. Yeah. Always getting aggy, shouting, acting like he's some kind of crazy prick. But the image that you're labelled with is fake as shit. Danny's a nice guy, a tarnished soul with a heart of gold. He works at Enable with disabled kids. At least they let him think that. You don't, they just let you in the office when you turn up in the morning because you look like a disabled kid. Fucking idiot. Right. Anyway, and he's always ranting about how he's against Scottish independence. Cunt, you need to zip it shut. The country he's fucked, but I'd rather be fucked on my own accord than by a bunch of fucking English cunts.
Whoa!
I'm decapitating Danny. I'm decapitating Danny. Giving his little dick a circumcision. He loves English folk so much. Next English rapper, he battles at Badmouth. I expect him to drop the mic and fucking kiss him.
Time.
Make some noise.
Let's do it.
Now he's been wanting this battle for a year, and all he's got, he's been wanting to battle me for a year, and all he's got is small jokes. For that, I think I should punch this guy now. I mean, it's ironic he's calling me small when 3/4 of your height are made up completely of eyebrow. And he talked about get hype. Well, let's cover that. Let's take the clock and turn it back. When I dropped it, it was a bumping track, but Insight said something that made other cunts react. He said that it was the worst beat in Scottish hip-hop history. The lyrics gave the upper hand. I was like, nah, mate, you don't understand. Z just keeps it gully, man. So just remember when the Scottish scene was criticising me for working with you, I was the only cunt that had your back. Off the top of it, man. I ain't even in my riffings, I get it popping. He's talking about criticising me and Scottish independence. You're for Perth. I can fucking guarantee that that's probably not even in Scotland. See, I come with our best wordplay. I went on a Facebook page called Perth 30, saw two sheep getting their head dogged away, and you on your 10th birthday. You are dead ugly, despite the fact you kind of look like a younger, darker Gary Barlow. If he was fucked for all his heart could handle and left with only half an arsehole.
Yes.
I want to stab you with a fucking scalpel and get your butt to blow me for fun. Fuck chewing on my scrotum and come, I leave that bitch choking on the fat like Ford Kiernan's son. That bitch is too big to even run. She looks like the cunt on the Michelin logo. You can find her Friday night on the dance floor with a chicken risotto. Fucking giving it, yo. You have syphilis, homo. Probably because you suck dick to such an incredible standard that you've got an infected glandula with genital cancer. I come with a venomous slander, a body and dismantled limbs. I feel no man in the battle ring, I tear a fucking man to win. And we all know gimmicks into steroids, protein, lifting weights and slamming gyms. So fuck your dungeon dwellers. Everyone apart from him. I'm on that fucking manic thing. I'm down to rip a dude to parts. You look exactly to the part. What I imagine it would look like if I ever tried to draw a fart. I'm living evidence this dude's a farce. Cause way before a copter hit the cliff of hard, you never had to go from Livingston to Glasgow for me to show you ruthless bars.
Oh! Yeah!
Make some noise!
Listen, you cocky midget. If you were any smaller, you'd be classed as non-existent. He goes to Tesco and they tell him he's 10 pence short. He goes fucking mental and starts battling the shop assistant. This non-consistent, cocky prick of a scrawny midget will not be winning. Danny, you've been lacking in battles lately. Putting less effort in because family life's getting the best of him. Helen's got this stupid prick pussy whipped and it's tripled his hormonal levels of the estrogen. All that nappy changing is depressing and it's stressing him, resulting in lack of content in his lyrics, and now the scene is thinking less of him. This man ain't equipped to handle a kid. He spends his nights crying, wishing that the bag in his dick when he was shagging his big slag of a bitch hadn't a rip. Why get a grip? You cancel out any talent you may have ever had because you're a motherfucking arrogant prick.
Yeah.
So pack it in, Tiny Tim. Because battle rap is not your profession. Faggot, go wind your neck in. I'll embarrass and disparage this ratty bloke in a second. I got D's world crumbling in front of him like DiCaprio in Inception. D's getting dethroned, left deceased, gutted and deboned. I'll deface D's face and beat his dome till his teeth are broken, leave the gift to decompose. No way to de-escalate the situation when I detonate my deadly statements. I'll hit him with no hesitation, this shit's mine for the fucking taking. So fuck a masquerade. I'll just amputate Danny's waist with a massive blade, rapidly lacerate the bastard's cavity, splash his face with acid waste and have him laid out in casualty. You need to open your eyes, Danny. Look through the illusion, past your delusions, and you might come to the very scary conclusion that your missus is actually a paedophile. Right? Okay. And having a midget boyfriend is just a temporary solution. Yeah. Okay. So fuck him, right? He's getting body bagged. Okay? You've already been body bagged, so they're gonna either have to fucking bury you inside a matchbox, okay? Bury you inside a matchbox in the fucking tree somewhere, right? Bury you inside a matchbox. You get bummed and you enjoy it, so they're either doing that, or they're gonna flush you down the toilet. That's it, right? Done. Fuck it.
Big noise for Z! Yeah.
Again, 2-1 to VD. I think that he took the first round. I think C took the second round. Quite impressed me. I thought it was hard, but then VD took it in the third round with the personal stuff kind of overrid the small jokes. So I'll give that to VD.
Sounds true. MCF. Buggy up on 2-1 to VD, man. I thought Z took the first, D took the second, third man.
Me and Mega have decided we're going to take this together. Have we? Because we're killing
this. Explicit, vile, ill lyrics, that's evil.
Fucking freeway.
Z took the first round, Weedy came though. Weedy came with some freestyles in the second round, that's why I think he took the second round for me. But Z took the third round, and he just came hard to read. Big up VD, but Z took it.
Right, so it's Alan Hansen and Gary Lineker.
Yep.
We're going to give you a post-match analysis. I think that was one of the best things I've ever seen Z do, but
yep.
I'm going to say straight away, I think that VD took that. How did you feel about D's performance?
D took it pretty hard. He was just now, I don't like the hardcore shit in it, but turn out the backstage sounds. That's your decision.
Who is it, VD?
Hi, we did. We did.
This one came quite close. We've got a 4-1 split decision, but the winner is. Hold the shot up. The winner is.
Hold the shot up.
We did! Yeah! Everybody make some noise for yourselves for coming out!
My mum said I can't come out today and I don't know why I'm still out.
And you should really be vlogging me, Keith.
It's good. Lunge from my dead hide, wash me up, be left, right, punch up, cunt in.